ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಚರ್ಯವೃತಿ ದಂಡೀ ಸರ್ವ ವೇದಾಂತ ಪಂಡಿತ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ವಿವೇಕಯೋಗಿ ಮಾಂ ಪ್ರಚೋದಯತು ಸರ್ವದಾ. ನೌ ಅವರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಪಾಸ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಯಂಗರ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ spiritual flavor which had been India's, which we seem to be losing by our own mad adoration of the West. Swamiji felt very, very deeply hurt and humiliated by the way Indians were adopting the Western customs and behavior and etc. So we are also having the same problem. Even after 150 years of Swamiji's appearing here on the Indian scenario, still our youth have not been able to absorb. So our problem is this: we should be to keep ourselves a living tissue. That is how we have started the topic. To keep ourselves as a living tissue and take India to her rightful place in the committee of nations, we as a nation should become aware that doesn't mean we belong to the same religion or same habit, nothing like that. Spirituality is something extraordinarily, magnificently expansive. It is not that a single pointed. It covers Isha Vasyamidam Sarvam Yat Kim Chil Jagatyam Jagat. So how to wean away our youth from this mad rush through the five senses to the enjoyments outside and get them focused on this inner source of strength and beauty, Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. That is our great challenge. Probably Swami Vivekananda and a lot of others who have come after him, they have all stretched this one point, said we have to come back to this grand central theme of Indian culture. So in one place, you know, Swamiji talking about, you know, in Chicago Parliament, he said, we not only tolerate the religions, but we also accept them as true. What does it mean? Put it in Sanskrit, you can say Sahishnuta and Sahanubhuti. We respond to the scientific content of the religion, religious teachings, and learn to appreciate the oneness in it, the truth in it. But then make that one truth, that awareness, part of our heart's culture. Our heart should respond Sahanubhuti. In an Indian scenario, what we find is this Sahanubhuti is getting lost. We fight with each other, we kill each other, we destroy each other. Even though we may pretend that we have the tolerant mind. So we have forgotten how to transform this toleration into acceptance, into sympathy in the heart, knowledge into sympathy. Then only we will be able to interact with the people and bring consolation to them. Where there is any conflict, if you want to stop that conflict, you should be able to tell to both parties that there is no need for conflict. This is the truth. And we feel the same for both of you. So that sort of a deep understanding, how we will be able to impart, that is very much needed in our country, as we all know. How much this sort of a Sahanubhuti, our heart responds to the need of the other. It may be an intellectual need, it may be an emotional need, it may be a material need, but our response to it should be from our heart and not from our head. So that is how now we will have to pass on to the younger generation, toleration combined with sympathy, sahishnuta combined with sahanubhuti. So in one place, Swamiji said, this is our idea of progress. Our progress should be this sort of a understanding. Then only the Vedantic ideal of progress should be bringing the human being nearer and nearer to the divine self. Then only he will be able to combine these and become a wholesome personality. So about that, he says, even in those days he felt youth energy has to be channelized. And there he says, to achieve this, it is necessary to inculcate in them a whole vision of life in which work assumes a new significance delinked from personal gains. Now we are going to pass into the Karma Yoga chapters of his talk. So, work delinked from material gains. Work assumes a new significance delinked from personal gains, rewards and recognitions. If we could combine these two in whatever small measure it may be, there would start a silent revolution transforming all the vital energies in our national life which are being drained today through unproductive channels into one harmonizing and integrating force for rebuilding our nation. Our youth energy, on one side the knowledge of the oneself, one truth combined with work, nishkama karma, if we could combine both, a wonderful force can be created. So, man-making and nation-building, that had been Swamiji's great aspiration. So, as we pass on to that, as we take up the strings of yoga, we have to keep this in mind. This jnana is to be combined with the other expansion of our personality. That is how now we have to combine both. So with this, we sort of conclude, sort of introduction to love India. She wanted us to love India because it's such a harmonious whole that with our day-to-day work. So, as we pass on to the yogic aspects of our national life's contribution, we should remember this and we shall take up in the succeeding lessons.